Ugly scenes on the streets of New York as a Jews for Trump rally descends into violence. A convoy of vehicles flying the flag for the president drove through the city. Some stopped their cars to showcase their rap skills. Others vocal in their support for Trump.
We're on the street, look at the cars, look at the support, Mr. President. We're coming out for you big time. We're going to win this election, hands down. We're going to tell de Blasio, our governor, we're going to teach this city what to do. Everybody, we love you. This is great. Everybody's going to be peaceful. Everybody's going to be not violent.
But they came under attack from counter-protesters in the street. A stone thrower on a bridge, a man films himself hurling eggs.
I got a bunch of these, baby. I got a bunch of them.
And a woman is arrested for using pepper spray. The Jews for Trump members were making their way to this rally in Marine Park, Brooklyn. 83% of Jewish people polled by Ami magazine said they would be voting for Trump. There are 5.7 million Jews in the US.
This is the greatest president and the greatest friend of the state of Israel, the Jewish people, in the history of this country.
Trump, meanwhile, staged his rallies in North Carolina and New Hampshire. And he was again upbeat on COVID, despite the US setting a daily record of 83,000 new cases on Friday.
If we cut our testing down in half, they'd say, well, they wouldn't say that, but cases would go down in half. Even without the vaccines, we're rounding the turn. It's going to be over. I don't know if I could ever get used to this again, going back to a normal where you actually have one doctor. You have a doctor for every single part of your body. Sure. And they want to touch you, too. They want to grab you. They, sir, I'm a specialist in this. Could I check this? I said I'd prefer not.
He also dropped into a farmer's market in Maine, New England, where he signed a pumpkin.
It'll be on eBay tonight. Okay, thank you very much. That's great, isn't it?
Plenty of pumpkins also on display outside the White House for the annual Halloween event. One young pair dressing as the President and First Lady. Joe Biden also flanked by pumpkins when he spoke in Pennsylvania on Saturday.
You know, I'm more optimistic about America's future than I've been since I've been involved in politics. We're the only country in the world that's come out of every crisis stronger than we went in. There's not a damn thing America can't do when we decide to do it together.
His support act, John Bon Jovi.
If you want to affect change and you can't do what you do, you can do what you can. Something as small as wearing a mask starts the ripple. Something as important as casting your vote next Tuesday is about the future of these United States that I so believe in.
I spent 20 years trying to get out of this place, looking for something.
Brad Pitt, another celebrity firmly in the Biden camp.
Someone who understands their hopes, their dreams, their pain, to listen, to bring people together, to get up every day, and work to make life better for families like yours. To look you in the eye, treat you with respect, and tell you the truth.
That advert played in a commercial break during the World Series Baseball Game 4. Trump hit back.
Here's how you can spot a zombie. Look for someone who has a corpse-like appearance, exhibits aggressive behavior, craves human flesh, and utters incoherent moans and groans.
I don't know.
With your help, we can prevent the zombie uprising.
I'm Donald Trump, and I approve this message.
Biden is believed to be ahead in the early voting. 59.4 million ballots have already been cast through the mail and in person. That's already more than last time round, with 9 days still to go. Trump cast his vote at the weekend in Palm Beach, Florida.
Who did you vote for today?
I voted for a guy named Trump.
Thank you very much, everybody.
And this is The Bronx Yesterday with Democratic Representative of New York, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
Frankly, this also shows the success of early voting as well. This is the first time that we've seen lines this long for early voting. Oh, yeah. So you know what? I'm extremely excited about that, and we're going to make sure that this is a smoother process. Love you too!
An academic with the U.S. Elections Project has predicted a 65% turnout. That's 150 million voters. That would be the most since 1908, when William Taft, a Republican, became president.